Hello and welcome to PSE program using CODESYS YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about refactoring and the ways to do it in CODESYS. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Refactoring is changing or updating the name of a variable or an object in a project in one place and having it updated automatically everywhere else in the project. You can do this in a couple of ways in CODESYS. To demonstrate it, I have one of my projects opened. As you can see here, to refactor a variable, you can right-click on its name, as I'm doing it here, and then choose refactoring, then rename that variable. If I click on it and provide a new name for the variable, then click on OK, a new window will be opened, which is for refactoring. On the left side, you can see in which objects that variable is used. Those are highlighted in yellow. And on the right side, if you click on each one of the objects, the place in which that variable is used will be shown. Now, if I click on OK, it means that I accept this change and the variable will appear with its new name. So clicking on OK, and you can see that there is a message from CODESYS as well. The routing mode will be switched into advanced routing mode. This is for the CFC only for the routings. Just click on OK, and then we have that variable rename. So that's what we have for the variables. For the POUs and other objects in the project, you can right click on the name of the POU and then choose refactoring, then choose the rename 7sec. Again, we need to provide a new name and click on OK. We will see a similar window opening. Again, it shows where that object is being used within our projects, highlighted in yellow, and choosing each one will also show where we are going to have changes. We can click on OK to accept it. And we also have the option to reject applying this change in one or any of the objects that we have here. If you right click on PSC underline PRG, for example, and choose reject this object, you see that that object will be highlighted in gray right now. So if I click on OK and apply changes, what we have for PSC underline PRG, it will keep the name as it was originally, but for the others, it will be updated. Please be careful in using this option. In the automatic refactoring dialog, you have access to configuring automatic refactoring options. If you click on it, options menu with refactoring selected will be displayed. There you can choose among different options. You can reach this from the tools menu as well. Another way to perform refactoring is to choose the variable or the object and then from the edit menu, choose refactoring and then rename. The rest will be similar to the previous approach. As you can see, another available option is reorder variables. If you choose this, you will see the list of the variables with the scope given. In this case, we have only input variables. And you will be able to change the order in which the variables will appear in the variable declaration area by just dragging and dropping the variables. In this special case, we have only two variables, so I can move and change the order for them. And once I click on OK, this refactoring window will open again and it will show that the variables will appear in the new order as you can see over here. Clicking on OK, we apply the changes and we will have the function block, in this case, updated. Once you click in the variable declaration area, by following the edit menu refactoring, you can see that there is another option, which is add variable. This will open the automatic declaration for the variables, where you can determine the name, type, initialize it, determine an address, and also the scope for the variable. So it's like introducing new variable to your project. That's it for this video. I hope you have enjoyed this video and have learned how to do refactoring in your projects. As always, don't forget to subscribe and suggest videos to your network. Thanks a lot for watching this video and see you next time. Bye for now.